A Canadian Radio Sanctuary podcast.
We were all enthusiasts about British Columbia history. Mm-hmm. Bill Barley's Canada West magazine was out. Rick and I had known about the Slumach legend, only part of which is true, since we were kids in the 1950s, and we first heard it around a campfire, mm-hmm. and we heard the legend of the cursed gold, yeah, and all that sort of stuff. So we'd known it since we were kids. We'd read about it and whatnot, but we decided in the early 1970s to actually research it and maybe publish a book, and that book came out in 1972. And it was called In Search of a Legend, Slumach's Gold. And it, in four editions, sold a total of 10,000 copies. Now, a bestseller in Canada is 5,000, so it was twice a bestseller. And then we eventually had a publishing company that grew from that. We published a total of 29 different works, various different authors and so on. And then into, we went on to other things, the three of us, and we sold the publishing company and our imprint and our titles off to Heritage House in Victoria. And as the 35th anniversary of this very successful book was coming up, we talked to Heritage House and they wondered about us doing an expanded version in the mid-2000s, as it were. So we started to do some research. By that time, there were websites. All sorts of people had been chasing gold in the mountains around Pitt Lake and all of that sort of thing. There were many, many stories to tell. And so what we ended up with, instead of this slim 56-page book that we published in 1972, mm-hmm. we ended up with 160 pages published in 2007. We reversed the title. We called it Slumach's Gold, In Search of a Legend. It went to the top 10 in the Vancouver Sun bestsellers, BC bestsellers list, within a couple of weeks and stayed there for 23 weeks. And it has now sold, in 7 years, another 10,000 copies. We're very pleased with that.
That's fantastic. Now, tell us a bit of the story. Those who are just itching to grab the book, go out and buy it. It's a fascinating story of the Pitt Lake area back in the late 1800s, 1890, around there. Yeah. And while targeting 1890, Slumach, tell us about this man and what got him into hot water, so to speak.
What little we know about Slumach is that he lived on the west shore of Pitt River in the Burke Mountain area, maybe the Widgeon Creek area of Burke Mountain, which is prominent. You can see it everywhere in the lower mainland. He lived, he hunted, and he was probably between 60 and 80. He wasn't a spring chicken. And so not much is known about him before then. But at some point, one day he was out hunting, and he had an altercation with a guy who he had disliked. They had had bad blood between them for years. And Louis B. apparently raised his tomahawk at Slumach, and Slumach shot him and killed him. And then he took off into the bush, and they hunted for him for 2 months. And all of this is a matter of record. It was in the British Columbian newspaper of the day. And so Slumach was in the bush for about 2 months, and they finally flushed him out, arrested him, got him to New Westminster, put him through a trial. The trial lasted about 3 hours. The jury was out for 15 minutes. White man's justice in those days, and they had to make an example of him and so on. So they sentenced him to hang. And on January the 16th of 1891, he hanged in what was then the provincial jail in New Westminster. And he was buried in an unmarked grave, and nobody knew until just a few years ago where that unmarked grave was. It turns out it's in the large cemetery in Sapperton. It's been found. He died in 1891. Now, by 1901, according to another story, there was a fellow named Jackson who showed up. He was on his way home from the Alaskan gold fields, showed up in New Westminster, and he heard tell of gold up in the Pitt Lake area. So he went searching for the gold, and he came back a few months later, a broken man, but he had according to the legend, he had a case backpack that he kept with him at all times. And when he got back to San Francisco, his home, he deposited around $8,500 in gold in the bank, which he had gotten out of the Pitt Lake region. That's another part of the legend. Very difficult to hammer down. But Jackson left behind a letter. He was broken. He was dying. So he sent a letter to a friend who had grub-staked him to go off into the bush and into the Alaskan wilderness. And he gave him a map and a description of how to find it. But it's sort of like, well, if you stand looking at this peak and then you can see three peaks in a row there, and you know, that sort of thing. So it's quite nebulous. But that letter, the Jackson letter, has circulated for over a century now. And people have been looking for the mine. Somewhere along the way, in the earliest reference we can find, well, the earliest reference to gold in the Pitt Lake area that's been published is 1905, when a guy named Fraser went looking up in the Pitt Lake region. The earliest reference we can get to Slumach's name is 1915. But somewhere between Slumach's death in 1891 and 1915, his name became associated with the gold. Also with a curse. Supposedly on the gallows, he said, Nikamemlus, mine memlus, which in Chinook means when I die, mine dies. So that's considered to be a curse on the mine. But the reporter who was there said Slumach never said a word. He went to his death without saying a word. So the whole curse thing is in doubt. But when people go looking for the mine and they fall off a cliff or they run out of grub and they break a leg or whatever and they end up dying up there, somebody says, aha, Slumach's curse has struck again. And so it goes. Now, one newspaper report from the 1960s said 63 people had died while searching for the mine. Presumably more would have done that by now. But in the 1920s and 30s and 40s, there were thousands of people every year went into the pit, into the North Pit, up Corbold Creek and in that area, looking for the gold. And there are various reports, some of them you would be skeptical about, some of them seem to have some validity, that people have found gold. But nobody's ever come back and said, I have found Slumach's lost gold mine. Whether or not it was Slumach's gold mine is in doubt. The word is that Slumach used to come to town with nuggets the size of walnuts and throw them around saloons in New Westminster. You look at a picture of New Westminster in 1890-91, it was a pretty developed city before the big fire. That word would have gotten out immediately. It would have been in the press that somebody is throwing around gold nuggets. There's no truth to that legend. But somehow people have found nuggets the size of gold somewhere north of Pitt Lake, and there seems to be some actual credible stories. Hmm. And the search goes on all these years later.
Is there any desire to add to this, Slumach's Gold, the book, do another book, or do you feel you've covered it all?
The next book should be called, we all agree, We Found Slumach's Gold. That would be the ideal thing. But if we haven't found, if thousands of people over the years haven't found it, why would we stumble upon it now? We've been doing some poking around up there now that my brother and I are both retired. Mary lives in the Okanagan. But when Rick and I have done a little bit of poking around, we will do some more. But it's all fun because we don't think that there's anything special. I have no gold mining techniques or abilities. Nor does he. We could pan something, sure. We could get some colors, of course. But are we going to find the mother lode, the stream that supposedly has, you know, you're knee deep in nuggets the size of walnuts? I don't think so.
Now, is that area of Pitt Lake, is it almost as much a wilderness area with no one around as much as it was over 100 years ago?
There are areas that have been logged, and so there's been that presence in there, and still that presence today. North of Pitt Lake itself, up the Pitt River, there's the famous Pitt River Lodge, wonderful location. There's Alvin, where there's a fish hatchery, and a lot of people stay at the lodge and go up Corbold Creek into the area east of the North Pitt River, looking for the gold. There are climbers, there are people who come through there just for a weekend lark. But, you know, the country's very, very rough. One person in describing it to us years ago said it's the worst topographical area in the province. And they were experienced with a lot of different areas in the province. So it's pretty wild. I've been up there. It is difficult. A lot of it's straight up. I mean, take a boat up Pitt Lake, as you're driving along on the water there, you see the mountain just rising straight out and going straight up. and that's on either side of you. So it's really, really rough country, and you have to be very careful. It's got grizzlies, it's got lots of black bears, it's got cougar, and wolverines and bobcats. None of them are things that you want to get involved with. And then, of course, there's the curse. So, who knows?
Okay. Slumach's Gold, thank you very much, Brian.
Thank you.